carbon fiber rock broken. Thing to repair the thing. I think still okay, but if strong wind, not stable. Repair the thing. And last for temporary hold for one night. Going back, then I have a permanent repair.
I have repaired the broken carbon fiber rods with these hollow tubes, which I use for my RC modeling. And also remove some of the light crack portion, and also replace with hollow tubes, which possibility of breakage, here one. Two, three, four. And I also replaced with new elastic rope. Now I'm going to modify this tentage for better weatherproof condition. This is my favorite light two-man tank. I have been using it since the early 90s, almost 30 years. I have just recently renewed the ground sheet. And the zip, all the zip. And this time I'm going to improve on the weatherproof condition. Because now rainy season, when heavy rain, the wind and the water very easily penetrate from the bottom inside to the tank, because there is no zig at the bottom. The front cover only has a zig at the vertical side, but not horizontal at the bottom, so the water and wind very easily penetrate. I'm going to make an extension about 2 inches from this bottom. With this synthetic fabric sheet, which I use for my RC modeling. And with this Velcro hook and loop tape to hold that extension on position.
right side.
Mosquito net. Okay, the bottom edge of the front cover is under the mosquito net. No way the water can go in now. And because of the risk, we are cool. The front cover. So now the weatherproof condition is much improved. Without putting on the mosquito net, now the front cover is still secure. This is a DIY pouch I made 2 years ago to put all the accessories, flashlight, power bank, headphone. And light material. So this the 30 years old light to maintain is ready for next campaign.
Now we are at the lunch hut. Lunch means we take the birds in a Malay. Noordin Estuary. take a half an hour break over here for a rest, because the backpack is too heavy here. I think this one 11 kg, that one's 8 kg. A life blonde. I think the whole package close to 3 kg. More than 3 kg. And this one's the container. Because most of my fishing gear is packed inside. Fishing gear over here, then the cookingware back over there. Now we are half the distance to the fishing destination. Luckily, when we reach this hut, we can encounter the showering. Now, I think we're going to stop here, the showering. So now we prepare to continue our journey to the northern beach. Now we are at the Noordin Beach. This one's the second hut. That one is the first hut. Now it's 5:30. So the tide is almost halfway. It's almost halfway to the maximum. 9:30 PM high tide. The height is 2.47 meters. Means you can see afternoon the high tide is almost here.
Is everything I need, and everything to me.
2.4 is almost here.
Baby, every single part is who you're meant to be. Cause you were meant for me.
Now we are at Punggol, Barra. You can see the wild boar.
Is everywhere.
So after 1 month, we are back in here.
Baby,
the previous campsite. So today, the maximum tide will be around here. You can see the, mark, 2.5 until here. 2.7 is up to here. 2.7. Because the weather is, today is not so good, so we need to set up the tentage now.
Thank you.
one settle the tentage, second thing is to settle the live one. PM. I think now is a golden hours for the Barra fishing. Back now. Luckily the rain has stopped, because today is 2 days to full moon phase, and the moon start rising from the east, and transit about 10 PM. The life rod important is not to mix the water first. So let the temperature inside and outside tally first. Wait until maybe half an hour or an hour, then you slowly mix the water. So now I set up my fishing rod.
Thank you.
Okay. Well, today I try something different. You can see the sinker is before the photo rig. Here is the photo rig. Everything the same, except the sinker. I'm not putting electrical here. I'm putting before the floater. Sinker, floater, shiver, leader line. Then you can see the sinker is movable. This is what I call the fixed point floater rig. The difference is you can see the floater will stay put at a certain spot. Because of the sinker is anchored at the seabed now. Because fishing at this bayou area, the river mouth, the current is very strong. You can see the floating object, you can see moving very fast. Because previous barra fishing over here, I think 90% of my live prawn was eaten by the other fish, the bottom fish. Catfish, eel, finger mark, duvana, but because of my hook too big. You see the porpoises stay put at the same spot. This is the advantage, there's a disadvantage of this design. Because when barra strike, it pull the rig, the photo rig, if you action too slow, the sinker will wreck by the barra at the seabed. That means very high chances the sinker will sanko at a snag at the seabed. You know, I designed this fishing rig 30 years ago when I start fishing at the Jolong Tong Beach. 30 years ago when I fishing there, I encountered the same problem because too many bottom fish. So I designed this fishing rig and now I call fixed point floater rig. But because of the disadvantage, I think about 60% of the barra fly end up the fishing rig sunko at the seabed and lost the barra loss because of the sunko. So I will see what's the result. Then after that, maybe I'll change to other fishing rig. You can see it's still there. The photo is still there. This is an advantage. So now I set up the second fishing rod. To use a mixed fishing rig, you need to put in the sinker first. Sinker. Then the DIY floater. Luminous holder, shiver, and the leader line 0.6 meter, 10 kg. And this I think the 20 size fishing hook, high carbon steel. If you like me using a budget fishing hook. It means a cheap fishing hook.
high carbon steel. Remember to make a twist at the hook here. You can see, because the cheap hook, in fact, is a flat form, so you need to twist a bit. You can see. So the tip is a little bit twisted from the body, a little bit offset from the body to increase the hook up chance. I mean, the chance to hook up is increased. So this is presently call the fixed point for the rig. The only difference is not only the sinker placed before the floater, also the stake you need to put on the other side of the floater. That means pointing away from the rock. That means here is a rock, sinker, floater. You know, my previous when I recommend the floater rig, the floater is putting this side. But this time, for this mix, fishing rig, the stake is putting this side. So this sinker will anchor at the sea bed. The floater will surface. And this side point up to the sky. Luminous stake. Then the fishing rig. So if Barra strike, the Barra proof, I mean you will see the your light signal and the bottle will like it. If there's a fish signal. Oh, because here anchor at the bottom. So if there's a signal, the signal will be like it. So this is the layout of my fixed point bottle, which I quit 30 years ago when I was fishing at the Yolong Tong Beach. Because the site also encountered the same problem. Too many bottom fish. Because I think most of the live form were eaten by the one cube. Over there, the Yolong Tong fish also the same. You encounter too many bottom fish. So if you want to fight a strong current and use a single rig, end up all your life bait were eaten by the bottom fish. If you use a photo rig, the photo will run away very fast. So now on the run.
Hiya.
So now put on the plunge. Current is very strong here. You see the barber is very fast. Until now, you can see the first fishing rod, the water still there. The terrain over here at this Sungai Besar. It's almost the same by the Sungai Rongtong. But this side, the Sungai Rongtong, both sides is the same like this side. Over there, the beach is not, it's not like here, got this very good beach over here. This side don't have, this side only got one very small patch on beach. And the only surface when low tide. And this side, the river is I think only 70% of here. It's not so wide. Both sides you can see is similar to the opposite side. Mangrove terrain. Not like this. The other reason why I quit this fixed point for tolling is because the sinker is sliding on the main line. Disadvantage of this is one of the major disadvantages over here. I don't like this, but because of, because I want to overcome the bottom fish issue, so I make a try again, see how. One thing because of the floater bottom don't have a weight, so you can see because of the stick too heavy, that's why the thing lie down. So maybe later on I'll put one small weight at the bottom of the floater to make the floater stand up. Now it's 7:30 PM. The floater of my two fishing rod all the time just stationed at the same spot. So now it's 2 hours to the maximum tide. Estimate the tonight the 9:30 the maximum tide will until here. So 2 days later the full moon phase, I think we're up to here. Then 2 days after the full moon phase, I think we're up to here. We're up to here. I mean at the end of the behind the tentage. I like to fishing here because I enjoy the view. Malaysia, Ang Chui Ling. Here is Sungai Besar. The old name 30 years ago, Sungai Batu Keke. Then 100 meters over there is they used to call the Noordin campsite. You can see the moon is coming out. The moon. So the moon will transit over there. No, I think over here. A bit offset to the south at 10 p.m. The weather forecast tonight will be raining. It's getting dark now, so I like to put on the this diameter 6mm luminous stick to the bottom. The fishing rod 4.5mm I have already put on here. I think this branch not so good, not so bright. Not so bright, only 50%. The pond still okay. One also okay. One okay. So you can see the advantage of this the mixed fishing rig, fixed point quarter rig. The quarter always stationed there, regardless of the how strong is the power. So now see what's the luck of the tonight.
I think the single sangkut at the bottom. When I handling this one, I saw the float was pulling by the fish. Moving in one big one. The rig just ten meter in front. Very heavy here. Oh yeah. Yeah, the feed loss is, I think, just the water running, pulling by the fish. And now like this. I think because this one right inside the snag. This is Punggol and the snag, then after that the fish, the hook gone. I think I'm too late because I'm just now I'm setting the other fishing rod. Broken at the fish hook joint area. I see if your action too small. You are saw the just on the fish pull of water one. So by the time I pick up the fishing rod, the sinker away from it and the snag under the water. That's why I quit this mixed fishing rig 30 years ago. Yeah. Always encounter this sort of problem. The sinker wrecking on the seabed. If you action too late, the sinker will sunk at a snag under the water. Very high chances. Let's see, I pull up the snag. Very heavy. When I pick up a rock, I saw the fish so big, splashing the water over there, just 12 meters in front of me. You know, pull the water one big round after splashing the water, jumping the water. I saw the fish so big. Never mind, because at the Bayou area, the chances very high for barra hunting. One rock, I still keep the mixed fishing rig. Then the 5.5 feet, I
I have already changed back to the single rig because I see more than enough the plot. Yeah, today the prawns are too many. Because the mixed fishing rig is very effective, but effective in the sense of where you save the live prawn from the bottom fish, but very difficult to handle. You can see the rig, the bottom rig still stay put in there. Now the current is running outward. I change to single rig, double hook. Start visiting it. Visiting until 4:40. So just on the tide until here. Yes, until the stroke. 2.4 meters until the stroke. If you come in 2 days later, the line will be up to here. Maximum tide will not be full moon phase or new moon phase. Usually it's 2 days after the 2 days after the new moon phase or full moon phase. Maximum tide 3 meters above. 3 to 3.1 meters. That means all the way inside. All the way inside.
Come on, eat.
Yeah. I'm afraid of it. Flathead. You see, a flathead is a bottom fish. That's why now go back to the same situation. But the flathead is a quality fish.
Bye-bye.
No internal bleeding, I think still got chance. Because out of the water too long, eh? It's not barra.
Usually the barra can last very long on land.
You can see no internal bleeding.
Good fish.
This one is a good fish. Mangrove jet. Never finger go inside the mouth. The mango jack is not like barra. Never go in the. Never go in your hand finger inside the mouth. You can see. You see? You see? Too deep, I don't want. Yes, sorry, remove.
Thank you.
jack is
Punggol jack is rare than Barra. Last time, 50 years ago, maybe 20 overs Barra, then we caught one Punggol jack. About this size, some even bigger. To replace one hook, you know, just now I cut the hook, because too inside. I don't want to remove the hook. Usually, for what how I replace the hook, usually I just like this. 1 meter line, loop knot, then I just put on the shiver. For my Apollo, usually like this. But now, never mind. Just make use of the existing Apollo. Then I just put on one more hook. Because the prawn too many now today, I don't think I can finish the prawn by the morning. I think around 10 a.m. No way. So now I upgrade my fishing rig to double hook. The fighting is not so good like Barra. You know, my target only Barra. The wild mangrove jack, I think more than 10 years I have not caught the mangrove jack before. More than 10 years. The wild one. Wild, very decent size of mangrove jack. Thank you.
Let me crack.
Now water running, receding very fast. Now it's 12:30. Minimum tide is 4:50. 0.7 meter. That is 40 meters away. So many hermit crab. One here, the ecosystem is not bad. That's why we got one mangrove jack. It's here the mangrove ecosystem is quite okay. Hope I can catch Barra. In fact, we turn back to here is to hope I can break the biggest barra record, because I lost the biggest barra over there I'm drilling, just few hundred away, and here is a river mouth system, so the chances to break my biggest barra, the chances is very high. The other way to check the live prawn whether it's still alive or not is looking at the eye. You can see the eye luminous. That means it's still alive. You can see shining. That's what the barra looking for, the eye, the prawn, the live prawn, the eye. Red luminous. So up to now, the result is this year I lost one barra, about 600 grams on one mango jack, very decent size. So, continue. Lovefish cube, 7x7. Colors are aligned, but there's a little, they call the party. But this one I left and go. Now I use this one, it's a party which is stated. Stated, okay. like me. So bring some skin you like for barra fishing. For you to enjoy the game and in the barra low activities. Sometimes I play the rubik skill, sometimes I play the chess. But most of the time I just enjoy the nature outside. It's a barra pulling already. Barra. My friend asked me whether to place your hook at the head portion or tail portion, which one is the better. Or just how the case, you can see, you put on a head, a front side, maybe we got a barra strike. But for my experience, if you hook at the tail, a nice one last longer. If you hook on the horns, usually will not last so long. But the chance is higher. That one I agree. one feed eel-tail catfish. Number three eel. So you can see how effective the single way. Always caught the bottom fish. I think now I change back to the mixed fishing rig.
Jumping, don't know what to do.
<音>上来！哎呀！哇，哇，真牛！哇，好大的一只！还好没有给它跑走。哇！
你看住啊。
你再拖长远一点，再让它冲冲下去。
Until morning, there I check the length. Could be the new record of my Ubin. Ubin the biggest bar record. Ubin lah, for Singapore. Hi. Usually I don't run the line up to put on the second fish. Usually I like this. They make a tight, but don't just make a tight. The main line goes through the loop. So if the knock feel, so if the knock feel, the main line still hold the metal hook. Is because just now after the eel, the fishing rig I changed back to the missing type, the fixed point, the floater rig. That's why I caught this barra. Because you can see after I changed the fishing rig back to the single rig from 11 p.m. All we caught just a bottom fish. You see the fighting, the floater, the condition. Oh, very tough. Huh? The fighting was very short. I think it's 10 times better than just now before the mango jack. 10 times I enjoy the fighting. The mango jack. That's why I only target at Barra. Not very sure. Until morning, then I measure the length. It'd be the my new Ubin's biggest barra that could be. That's why I don't like the waist line.
Yeah,
don't like the brave one. Wow, you see, that's why just now. Because high carbon steel is too weak for the big barra. If a barra more than 0.8 meters, considered as an adult barra, that means that the sex has already converted to female. You can see the hook already straightened out. That's why just now the hook came up and luckily already pulled to the shore. I think I just said I just convert the single rig to this mixing fishing rig. This fixed point. This fixed point motor rig. I think less than 50 minutes. Then I caught this big barra. So maybe later on I'll just convert. This fixed point on the photo rig. Outgoing main string is on the top, not the bottom. Then here is a movable sinker. This is a concept of the fixed point water rig. Here will anchor at the sea bed. Then this one will surface to the water the surface. Then the rigs always keep on top at the top. The face of the water. all the prawn gone. Some friend asked me, what is the best timing for the floater rig to fight a fish? What's the best timing? Now I'm sharing. Also taught by my senior fishing kaki 30 years ago. When you see the floater sink down, you don't pull the rod. When the floater surface and start to sink the second time, it's the time for you to pull the line and start fighting with Barra. This is the best timing. It means the floater sink in for the first time, surface, then sink in the second time, then you're gonna hold your rod, start fighting with the Barra. For the Barra spring, I think 100 meters away. Your pile will turn quick again. Okay, okay. Okay. Oh, turn again.
Ali. Let's be poor. Low. Ali. Come here.
Voilà. The Barra still, I think still not tired yet. Could be the big Barra. Oh, get this side. I'm not being scared too at that. Wow, get this side.
Yeah, I will almost find out here.
What's the hook, right? What is above low HG? What is the hook? Hey. You see, just like this. Just on the soft tissue. Usually the Barra can last very long
on land. Now is the tide, 4:30. The tide start rising now. Here usually I make 2 knots, 1 and 2. Fighting shore. Barra means Barra. Fighting damn shore. I just cast the fixed point quarter rig straight ahead, but when the Barra strike is clean about 100 meters to the left, means inside the river. This is a standard steel one. I prepare for sea Barra. The previous one, they want a high carbon steel. In fact, I prepare the rig for the pond fishing one. This one is standard steel. Big Barra and the Minggong jet, you can see I just cast the rig less than 10 meters away. You can see less than 10 meters. What a fighting damn shot, man.
Oh.
So just now, the second barra, you can see the hook just hooked at the soft tissue. So they all consider it very lucky. That's why many friends ask me when for the live baiting, if barra strike, whether you need to pull the line or not. Very hard to answer this question. Because from all my vlog, you can see I never pull the line when the barra strike. Why? Because just on the case, just hook on the soft tissue, happened many times to me. If I pull the line, the soft tissue will broken. You will lost the barra. Because 30 years ago, my senior fishing kaki told me, if you are live baiting for barra fishing, quarter weight, when you see the barra pulling the floater all over the place, I mean consider as the hook already on it. You don't need to pull the line. That's why I, until now, all these 30 years, I follow exactly like what he say lah. I never pull the rock to set the hook deeper. I never. Drinking my favorite coffee. Listen to the favorite music. Fishing at good mangrove ecosystem, the river system. And encounter this kind of incredible barra fishing result. That's so well. That's great, okay, man. Now is 15 a.m. You can see the line, the water line is already up in here. So we need to pack up everything and make the move.
Ubin's
and 3/4 inches. That means 1 inch smaller than the moon.
You can say I'm wrong. You can turn your back against me. But I am here to stay. I am here to stay. Like the sea. She keeps kissing the shore.
Mango's jack, 15 inches.
No matter how many times he pushes her.
So estimate this one. Maybe 3 kg above. This one I think more than 2 kg, maybe 2.5. This one could be